So in
ठीक
this
है सर,
syllabus, basic principle of
मतलब
mass spectrometry, significance of m plus peak in or m by z in determination of molecular formula, rule of 13 also in included in your syllabus, then genesis of some fragment given for the alkene, alcohols and amines. So problem based on 2-3 fragments above mentioned functional group should be discussed in this 2019 pattern syllabus. So first introduction. So mass spectroscopy is the best analytical technique that measure mass to charge ratio of ions. So ions, particularly positively charged ions, are detected in mass spectroscopy, and which is the basic tool for organic chemist, because once you synthesize your compound, newly compound, you have to give to mass. If your mass matches, means that compound is as expected, you synthesize and then go to NMR, IR, CMR, that rest. If your mass is matches, then you will go for NMR, NMR, CMR, IR, like this. So if your mass is not matching, means your compound which is you expected to synthesize is not formed in this case. So bus basic, that is the mass is very important for, as concern of organic chemist. So that mass spectroscopy is a powerful analytical techniques used in quantifying the material to identify unknown compounds within a sample and to educate the structure and chemical property of different molecules also. The complete process in mass spectroscopy involves the conversion of sample into gaseous ion with or without any fragmentation, which then can be characterized by their mass to charge, that is m by z or m by e ratio, and their relative abundance. So mass spectrometer generates multiple ion from the sample which are under investigation. It is then separated them according to their specific mass to charge ratio and then record the relative abundance of each ion, each type of ion in mass spectrum. So there's a basic principle in mass spectroscopy. Your organic molecule are bombarded with electrons. So we are considering of organic chemistry. So your organic molecule first injected in a mass spectrometer, and in that mass spectrometer, that organic molecule is bombarded with electron. Electrons pay there, so it is bombarded with electron. Due to that bombardment of electron, the second step is a molecule converted into highly energetic positive charge ions. That is called as a molecular ion or parent ion peaks. So once you bombard electron on molecule, the molecule loses electron, its electron, and form positively charged ions. So once one electron from your compound is ejected or it is released from that molecule, so if one electron loses from the molecule, molecule will get positive charge. That is a loss of electron giving the positive charge. Loss of electron is called as a molecular ion peak, or it is called as a parent ions of that particular molecule. The ions form further break into smaller ions. Once the molecular ion form, it may undergo fragment or further it is cut down into smaller fragment in the mass spectrometer only. So that ions are called as a fragment ion or daughter ions. So these are formed in the next step once the molecular ion form, and that molecular ion or their fragment ion daughter ions form ion are separated by deflection in magnetic field according to their mass to charge ratio. Once the fragments are formed in this mass spectrometer instrument, they are separated. Okay, same mass are separated, they are deflected from the magnetic field. Okay, those who are having same fragments, similar fragment or same mass by charge ratio, they are deflected and they are moving towards detector with different speed. So here, last step in this principle, M by Z ratio versus intensity are obtained in a mass spectroscopy. That is the relative abundance of peaks versus M by Z ratio. So that M by Z gives you that mass of a particular fragment or mass of particular molecular ions. So that is a basic principle. So this is shown by a tree diagram. Here it is given in the theory type. So first step in mass spectrometric analysis is of compounds is the production of a gaseous phase ion of a compound. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Are you able to see screen?
No, sir.
No?
Okay. No.
No.
Now?
Yes, sir.
Yes? Okay.
Yes.
So in a basic principle, that is the first step. When you inject your compound, which is dissolved in some solvents, okay, depending on how which type of your mass spectrometer. So it is dissolved in a suitable solvent and injected in this mass spectrometer. And the first step of that mass spectrometer is the first step in mass spectrometric analysis of compound is the production of gaseous phase ion of the compound, basically by electron ionization with bombardment of electron to form a molecular ion or parent ion. So once you inject your compound dissolving in some sample, it passes to electron ionization, where the bombardment of electrons takes place on your molecule, and your molecule will lose one electron to form a molecular ion, or it is called as a parent ion. This molecular ion undergo fragmentation to form positive charge ions or neutral ions or radicals. So this is second fragmentation, or called daughter ion formation. So first, so loss of electron gives you to parent ion, and from parent it further undergo fragmentation. Fragmentation means breaking of that molecule into small pieces. That is called as a daughter ions. So each primary product ion derived from molecular ion in turns undergo fragmentation as so on. So that molecular ion gives daughter ion, that daughter ion also gives their daughter ion. So that's such a fragmentation possible in this mass spectrometry. So once you bombardment of electron, breaking of molecules takes place in that mass spectroscopy. The ions are separated in this mass spectroscopy according to their mass to charge ratio and are detected in proportion of their abundance. So that mass to charge ratio, how much molecules are fragmented in same M by Z, they are giving the abundance of that particular M by Z. So in mass spectrum of molecule and thus produce, it is display the result to form a plot of molecular ion versus mass to charge ratio. So you will get a line, sharp line, like of that particular mass versus abundance, how much that percentage of that particular fragment, molecular ion fragment or fragment ions or the daughter ions, the abundance to the 100%. From 100, how much they are generated. Ions provided information concerning the nature and structure of their precursor molecule. That this ions gives the idea about which is your precursor molecule and from which your fragment will form. So in this mass spectrum of pure compound, the molecular ion present, it present and appear at the highest value of M by Z, followed by ion containing heavier isotopes, and gives the molecular mass of the compound. So which is the highest mass in your compound, simple in a simple mass spectrometry, that is your molecular ion mass. So from this we can conclude. So this is basic principle. If it is asked basic principle of mass, you have to write that flow sheet, and with the flow sheet you have to explain the this theory of mass spectroscopy. Okay, so any problem regarding to this? Hello? About principle?
No, sir.
Now next point is principle mein. In mass technique, molecules are bombarded with beam of energetic electrons. The molecule are ionized into positive and broken up into many fragments. Some of these which are positive. Each kind of ion has a particular ratio of mass to charge, that is m by e or m by z ratio. And for most of ion, the charge is 1, and thus m by e ratio is the simple of molecular mass of them. So m by e ratio or m by z ratio is calculated by their mass only, because if you take mass to charge ratio, but charge for a particular fragment if 1 plus only, then m by z or m by e is nothing but your molecular mass or your mass of that fragment, which calculated by taking atomic mass of atoms for a particular fragment or particular compound or particular molecule. So instrumentation and working. So this is a basic principle. Basic principle include, that is the injection of your sample, bombardment of electron on that. That molecule or your compound loses one electron to form molecular ion. And once the molecular ion form, it further undergo fragmentation. That molecular ion or parent ion is giving to so fragmentation ion called as a daughter ion. And then further this daughter ion also undergo fragmentation, gives next fragmentation. And when such fragmentation ions are formed, they passes to the detector through a magnet. Okay, and they are detected by their m by z ratio versus abundance. So in this instrumentation, it is given here. So it is given by inverted V-shaped pipeline like structure. So first is a probe where you inject your sample. Then second part, first is the ionization, second is the accelerator. So in this part, there is a spraying of electron or throwing of electrons. So here electron beam is present from which electrons are passed through this cavity. And here accelerator plates are there, slits are there, so that electrons are here collecting to another cathode or anode like structure. So here ion source is there. So in this region, bombardment of electron takes place and formation of ions in this region takes place. Then it is passes through this chamber, and having third part is a magnet. Okay, so in a magnetic field, this m by z ratio, okay, because once the here electron passes there, they having different m by z. Here it is a shown magnet, which is ions are deflected in different direction. One is going like up direction, one is going straight parallel to that line, and one is deflected towards lowers. And from this it is going to detector, and you will get a record here. So this is construction of mass spectrometer or instrumentation of mass spectrometer. So here 4 points. One is the ionization, second one is the accelerator, third one deflection, and four is a detector. And having there is probe, ion source or electron beam, then it is a insulator part is there, ion beam, magnet, ions, then a flight tube where this molecule passes through a long chamber. There is a flight tube, and it is going to detector. So here having detector slits and detector which record the m by z versus abundance of that m by Z. So that is the instrumentation diagram for instrumentation. So working for this MS, there are four key steps in this process of mass spectrometry as discussed. That is the ionization first step, ionization of a given compound, then acceleration of that fragments, then deflection of fragments and detection of fragment takes place in this. So this on the basis of four step your mass spectroscopy work. So ionization, acceleration, deflection and detection of mass. Okay. So let's see one by one. So first step is ionization. So in this ionization, the initial sample may be your solid sample, liquid sample or gaseous sample. The sample is vaporized into a gaseous and then it is ionized by ion source, usually losing an electron to become a cation. So here ionization of your compound takes place by losing of one electron. If one electron loses from your molecule getting positive charge and one electron loss. Like you can you write like in a complexes one electron. So here this molecular form called as a that cations. Okay, so this electro ionizing is the most common type of ionizing technique used, electro ionization nowadays, or electron bombardment. So the sample is bombarded by electron which come from a heated filament. So that is the instrumented part, a heating filament, how this electron produce. When the sample passes through the electron stream, because from that chamber you are making that electron bombardment, and when the sample passing through that chamber, the high energy electron in this stream knock electron out from the sample to form an ion. So that electron bombardment of your molecule and that electron pick up or knock out the electron from your sample giving the positive charge ion. That is called as the molecular ion or parent ion. So ionization chamber is kept in vacuum so that the ion that are produced can process through a through the instrument without running into molecules from air. So vacuum is kept in this chamber because without running into a molecule from the air. So that is first step, ionization, bombardment of electrons on your sample. And your sample loses one electron to form a molecular ion. Okay. Now, second stage is the acceleration. So acceleration is a simple step where ions are placed between a set of charged parallel plates. So in this ions will then be repelled by one plate and attracted to other plate. There is a slit cut in the plate which the ions are attracted to. And the force of attraction and repulsion forces in the ion through that slit can accelerate the rate. The speed of acceleration can be adjusted by changing the charge on the plate. So the purpose of acceleration giving all species the same kinetic energy and like to start the race with all runner with the same line. So that is acceleration is used. That is in ionization that molecular ions are formed that further undergo fragmentation also in these regions in acceleration that are these fragments form are attracted towards the particular charged plates, okay, and repel from other plate like this. So here the fragments form, they are lying in one plate or they are lying one line to start the race because they have to go to detector. So once fragment form, they are accelerated, they are giving kinetic energy to them, okay, and from this their race is started to go to detector. Okay, so in this region fragmentation ionization takes place, and in acceleration there is kinetic energy given to them so that they will start their race toward the detector. Then deflection area. So in this deflection, ions are deflected by the magnetic field surrounding the instrument. So one magnet is kept to produce a magnetic field in that instrument. So the amount of deflection depend on mass to charge ratio of in the ion. So which is having heavier ion, okay, they having heavier m by z, and which is a lighter ion, lighter fragment, they having lighter m by z ratio. So according to their mass to charge ratio, they are deflected in this magnetic field. Okay, those who are lighter, they can deflect one direction. Those who are having heavier, they deflect in another direction. Those who having medium, they are maybe not deflected, or they are going straight from this magnetic field like this. So the lighter component or components with more ionic charges will deflect in the field more than the heavier or less charged component. Okay, the lighter component or which is having more charges, they are more deflected in magnetic field than the heavier fragment or less charged fragment. The heavier ions are deflected at least, that is on stream in the instrument, and the lighter ions are deflected most. So here the which are heavier, they are not deflected because they are having more m by z ratio, they having more mass actually, so they are not deflected due to heaviness. And lighter which are deflected in ion stream, so in this here when from this accelerator they are passing to the magnetic field, that is a race start, but same at the same time you have to separate this ions, okay, to separate that magnetic field is used. Okay, here in this magnetic field the ions or fragments with charges are passed, they are deflected, they change their direction. So those who having light fragment, they bend to the this direction, and those who are heavy, they are not bent, they are going like a straight direction here. So here they are going like a straight and bent here lastly, and those are heavier, they bent in starting, and from this they are going to detector here. So in this deflection, heavier are least deflected, where at light ions are deflected more. So the ions at the correct mass to charge ratio travel into the detector by that stream beam, means middle line. So the mass to charge ratio is determined from the ion that hits the detector. That is, they are passing and they now going to detect on detector. So they are going to hit on the that detector. So last step is the detection of that molecule, because you are separating here ions according to their mass by charge in a magnetic field. Now the race is somewhat changes here, because the lighter are going fast now because they are bending and going to detector fastly, where are heavy atoms are not bended, so they are going slowly from that. Step 4, when the ion stream reach the detector, that hit on wire of the detector. On hitting the wire, they become neutral by an electron jumping from the metal wire to that ion. Okay, so in this detector, the wire is there on detector. So this charged particle, when they heated on that wire, they pick up the electron from this wire and become neutral. And this amplifier pick up on this current being created between wire and the ion, and the amplifier signal become detected. So how much that amplifier pick up from the current, that is to take the electron, is detected in this detector. Okay, so that is a electronics part here. So how much energy which is required to gain the electron, that is amplifier here, to gain the electron is detected by detector, and that is computerized and converted into their mass to charge ratio and produce a simple that mass spectrum versus that is a mass of mass to charge races versus the abundance, because you, in this race mass m by z have fragments which is having similar, they come one in a crowd. So if a crowd is larger, you will get more abundance, and those who are having less crowd, their abundance is very less. So they are detected in this detector, and you are getting signal mass by charge ratio versus number of that fragments or ions. How many fragments are there out of 100 you can detect here. So that is the working of mass spectroscopy. So any doubt in this mass spectroscopy?
Yes.
Hello? Yes. Any doubts in this mass spectroscopy?
No, sir.
Okay, it is straightforward question. Ask working instrumentation and working in mass spectroscopy. So you have to draw diagram and explain this all thing. Okay.
Yes.
Here, the ionization techniques used in mass spectroscopy and their source, because electronic bombardment is used in that simple EI technique, that is electron impact ionization. Nowadays, it is changing the source to form the molecular ion peak or that parent ion. So initially, the bombardment of mass takes place. Nowadays, the techniques are going change. Different source are used to produce a molecular ion peak. So this is given in only side in detail, not in your syllabus. Maybe in second year, you having this. So let's look one slide for that. So ionization technique and their source in mass spectrometry. So there are many types of ionization method for formation of molecular ion, or called as a parent ion in a mass spectroscopy. So first is a gas phase source. So in which gas phase source is first electron impact ionization. It is denoted by EI. So it is the source is a energetic electrons, a bombardment of electronic electrons here. Second technique is a chemical ionization technique, so to produce your molecular fragmentation or molecular ion peaks. And here the reagent gases ion used for making of your fragment or ions for that. And third in gas phase source is a field ionization. It is denoted by Fi. So it is highly potential electrodes are used to making molecular ions or fragment ions. So that is a gas phase source. Second is a desorption sources like field desorptions, FD. So in this, high potential electrodes are kept in this ionization chamber to get a fragmentation or a molecular ion formation. Then electrospray ionization technique called as a ESI. ESI source is used as a high electric field. In from this high electric field, your molecule or compound form a fragment, so that a molecular ions, parent ions or fragmentation takes place. Or next one is a MALDI, that is a matrix attested desorption ionization. It is the source used to make the ions is a laser beam. Then plasma desorption is a PD. Here fragmentation from CF to 53 element from this fragmentation carried out. Then fast atom bombardment, FAB. So here atomic beams, energetic atomic beams are used to produce ions. Then thermospray ionization, TS. Here by high temperature that ions are formed. And secondary ion mass spectroscopy, that is called seems energetic atomic beams also using this technique. So detail in your syllabus is not there. Maybe in second year you are having that. So that is the techniques which are used to form ions in this mass spectroscopy and their sources. So which source is used to make a that technique or that fragments from your bond. So that is about theory of mass spectroscopy, basic principle, introduction and principle in mass spectroscopy. For a reference, you can read the Pavia book is there in this mass spectroscopy chapter, or Silverstein in this also mass spectroscopy, mass spectrum gear. Both books are good. You can read from that both book, Pavia and Silverstein book. Okay, so here we can take a break. You will get a break, and after that you can join the next session.